We were first here as researchers 15 years ago. It was an eye-opening experience. Solomon Islands sits at the far southeastern extreme of what is the Coral Triangle, which is the richest region for biodiversity in the ocean.
3, 2, 1.
The fishes and the clams are some of those organisms that take advantage of all of the biogenic habitat which is created by those corals. It really left an impression on us. And so to be able to come back with slightly different assets.
I think, is that targeted too?
To access different questions here is a really exciting opportunity. So once again, thank you everyone for all the hard work that you've done over the last probably 18 months to get us to the point where we are now. Looking forward to getting underway. Ours is the third and final leg of this research expedition. And we're here to focus on the biodiversity of Rennell Island and Indispensable Reefs. We've got a number of sites at both of those locations that we're hoping to target over the next 3 weeks, focusing on what's going on at the mesophotic depths where there is less light available to fuel biodiversity. And at those locations, we'll be running 3 very distinct operations at the same time.
We're here at SCUBA-based. We're just about to launch Sky for the first day of BRUV Ops, and we're all frothing. D1 recording. Good?
Yep.
Overall output's going to be looking at characterising the fish biodiversity across the depth gradient. The video allows us to get really fine scale measurements of fishes, which allows us to then extrapolate that into estimates of biomass, which is used around the world for things like comparing the effectiveness of marine reserves. Oh, great drop. Whoa. And we just saw a tiger shark as well, so that's a good start.
One of the big questions that's sitting out there at the moment is how are organisms going to respond to climate change? Is there capacity within populations to be able to adapt to the changes that are coming? So we'll be doing the shallow water diving collections on 2 different organisms to determine what characters in those populations are determined by their shared genetic history. With the giant clams, we take just a very small tissue sample from the mantle, so the growing part. The other technique that we use for sampling the fishes is using an anesthetic. It allows the fish to be sedated underwater in a way that we can then maintain all of the morphology of that fish in order to be able to extract as much information out of them as we possibly can.
SO, Cthulhu, can confirm hatch is secure.
Copy that, hatch is secure.
With the submersible video surveys, we get an idea of what's happening at slightly deeper depths.
Hey, that's a xanthochelys, which we haven't seen on a BRUV yet.
Those ones that are targeted species in local markets.
Yeah.
We're really privileged and fortunate on this leg of the expedition to have 2 representatives from the Solomon Islands Ministry of Fisheries joining us to really give us that local view on the species which are harvested.
Oh, there's a lobster on there.
The region where it sits biogeographically at the edge of the Coral Triangle and then connected to the Great Barrier Reef means that what happens here in the Solomon Islands regionally is really quite important. It really gives us an opportunity to place our local findings into the context of what's happening in the Pacific. It's an incredible opportunity to really dig into processes that are driving biodiversity in these ocean spaces.